Michal charges $20 plus $3.50 per mile to rent a truck. If the total bill for a rental was $163.50, how many miles were driven? Okay, let's take a look. We know the total bill is $163.50. So that equals to the $20 plus $3.50 per mile times the number of miles. So I'm going to put my $20 here plus $3.50 times, I don't know what, so we put an X. So how did I know I was going to put $3.50 times X here? Well, $3.50 per mile, that's the way you figure out the cost. If it's $3.50 per mile, which is the rate, you need to multiply by the number of miles. And that's what we're trying to figure out. And when you don't know something in math and we're trying to figure it out, we'll assign it a variable. Then we can go ahead and solve from there. So solving this algebraically, we want to get this x by itself, so subtract 20 from both sides. And so that's going to make 0, and then 350x. We don't need the parentheses here, really. Equals, and then subtract here, 143.50. So to finish solving for x, you're going to divide both sides by 350. So let's figure out 143 divided by 350. Get the calculator. So 143.50 divided by 3.50, 41. So x equals 41. And our answer is 41 miles. The question was how many miles are driven. If our answer is 41, it's 41 miles. And also there's a way to solve this with a more visual model. Okay, we have, let's say this represents the total bill. And there's going to be one over here. It's supposed to be roughly the same size. Now this is 163.50, and we know this is 20, and then we have the mileage part, and we know that's 350 times the number of miles. Put a question mark there, or you could put an X, you know, that's really what we're doing with the equation. But anyway, we want to figure out the mileage cost plus the original cost of $20 to get started. Why is that equal to $163.50? Well, we know the $20 can be taken from here and from here, and that changes this number to 143.50. And see, that's the subtraction step right here in the equation. The first subtraction step was taking $20 from both sides. And so that left with $143.50 and the mileage part, which is 350 times something. So what we need to do is then divide it so many times to make $143.50. So you would just keep dividing however many that is to make 350 times the number of miles, 143.50. And that's this division step right here, this $3.50. That's why we were dividing it. You want to know how many times you can divide the 143.50 into parts of 350. And it turned out with our division it was 41. So you can make 41 little divisions of 350, and each division represents a mile. So that's a more visual way to solve the problem without even really messing with the equation. But I hope you can see the connection between the way this equation is set up and the way the visual model is set up. It's really the same type of thought process. One is more concrete, which is the visual model, and one is more abstract, which is the algebra model. And you can use either technique to solve this type of a problem.